Oh, hey guys, Ronatime HD here. You just caught me. I was about to listen to Huey Lewis in the News, sports. You know, this is what got me to listen to Huey a lot more seriously, because people don't listen to the lyrics, but they should. Because not only is it a commentary about friendship, but it also talks about the band itself. Paul, welcome to Off the Shelf. Ah! Okay, anyway. Okay, what a way to open the video. But yeah, as you can see, if you can't tell by my get up here, we watched American Psycho.
You know, I'm utterly insane. I'm into murders and executions mostly.
Do you like it?
Well, it depends. Why?
I just
have to kill a lot of people!
What we found off the shelf this week was American Psycho, made in 2000, directed by Mary Harron, starring Christian Bale. And honestly, if you couldn't tell by me doing three skits and me cosplaying as Christian Bale, like a subtle cosplay, I guess, I really like the movie. And I just really like Christian Bale's performance. I just think he's really good at playing an absolute crazy person. And I think the name really fits. And also, I haven't read the book yet, but I think I should get to the book, because I'd probably like the book. If I liked the movie, I'd probably like the book. But then, I just also thought it was really well written, and there's actually, I think the dialogue was really great. It was actually, it's a satire of the 80s, but it still felt like somewhat believable. Not the part where he ran through the streets, like, going postal, just shooting everybody. That wasn't that believable, but it was pretty funny. There were some pretty funny parts of this movie. I wouldn't say it was a comedy, but I would say it had comedic elements. Mainly with how, like, nonchalant Patrick is about everything. I think that's really funny on how, like, he can't show any emotion, because that's just, he's incapable of doing that. So, whenever something serious happens, he says he needs to go to return some tapes or something, and he leaves. So it's like, I think it's really, just really funny. At points. And then he can actually be really scary, too. Like, Christian Bale can be really scary in this movie. And I just love it. I love this film, I love his performance, and especially, I love the story itself, because there's many ways a story can be interpreted, but the way I interpret it is that he didn't actually kill anybody. I don't think Patrick actually killed anyone. I think he was just crazy. Like, he's crazy in the film already. Like, the film establishes he's really fucking crazy. But I think he's just fantasizing killing all these people, because at the end of the movie, he sends a voicemail to his lawyer, where he confesses to all the murders, right? And his lawyer doesn't call him Patrick. He calls him Davis, which is not his name. And they talk about Patrick Bateman like he's a different person. So I also have a theory that maybe he's not even Patrick Bateman, or maybe, like, there's some split personality disorder going on. Not sure. But near the end of the movie, he's like, "What do you mean? Paul Allen isn't dead. It's not possible. I had dinner with him 10 days ago in London." So, like, it really just shows that Patrick was just fantasizing and he wasn't really killing people. Or you could just interpret it another way, but that's how I interpreted the film. And I thought it was really ridiculous at a point, like, when he was chasing the lady down through the hallways with a chainsaw, like, naked, chasing her down the hallways with a chainsaw. It was great. It was really great. And honestly, I feel like, I just feel like you should watch this movie if you haven't already. Like, I highly recommend it. If you're a fan of the horror genre, honestly, if you're not a big fan of this kind of movie, if you're not a fan of, like, horror or, like, gore, like, blood or whatever, like, murderers, because the main character isn't very likable, You can like him, but that's not because he's a good person. He's pretty terrible. But, like, I feel like every fan of horror, every fan of thrillers should just go out of their way to see this movie. You know, because it's like, it's just perfect. You know, it's a perfect satire without being a slapstick comedy, and it's a perfect horror without being, like, too scary. You know what I mean? Like, I think it's a nice blend of satire and horror. It's just brilliant, in my opinion. And I know not everybody thinks that way, but I do. And I just love this movie so much that I got all this. So I highly recommend it for horror fans and thriller fans alike. If you haven't seen it already for some bizarre reason, I highly recommend it, and you should go out of your way to watch it. Really recommend it. Now, I rate this film a 9 out of 10. 9 out of 10, absolute amazing film. Highly recommend it, and if you haven't seen this movie, see it right now. And I think I've said my piece. You know, hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you liked it. Turn those notifications on. Subscribe, turn those notifications on. Share with your friends. Comment down below on how much you liked it. Also, guys, let me know what your favorite Huey Lewis in the News song is. I really want to know. I mean, I already have one on record. Maybe I need to buy more of them. I must have every single album released by Huey Lewis in the News. But, signing off.
You know, I'd love to talk about American Psycho more, but I've got to go return some tapes.
I should be making a happy face. I'm reviewing American Psycho. I should have a deadpan face throughout the entire movie. What's this?
It means go!
Fine! But anyway, as I was saying...